Hi everyone. Today I want to share with you why as a C++ low-level developer I find Go really awesome. First thing is that I develop concurrent applications in C++ every day and it's a real pain because it's complicated. Your program intent is diluted into synchronization tooling. It's really verbose, you have to write a lot of code to do really simple things. And it's really delicate, just one step out of the way and everything can blow up. So, why is Go so awesome? With Go routines, you can break the code into very logical parts. Thanks to the net parler, you don't have to bother with callbacks or with event loops anymore. And you can write your application as a pipeline. With channels, it's really easy to write data flow. So, Go routines, how does it do it? The first answer is ASM code. Go is written with assembly and Go exclusively, except for the CGO module. The context switching. When a routine has to get back to the scheduler, that's what we call a context switch. In Go, this is really fast. We can compare this to the context switching in a classic operating system between processes or threads. It's up to 4,000 nanoseconds. If you pin a process or a core to a process or a thread to a particular core, it's up to 2,000 nanoseconds. But with a Go routine, it's less than 10 nanoseconds. The thread local storage is what is used by the Go routine to find the scheduler. Classic thread local storage can be costly. But Go is really smart about it, and it uses some assembly tricks to make it faster. For instance, on Intel processors, it uses a MMU registry, if it can. The NetPorter. The NetPorter is integrated directly in the scheduler, and it unpacks Go routine only if there is some I/O available for them to execute. It uses different system calls depending on the operating system. EPOL for Linux, I guess some of you know about this one, KQ for macOS, and I/O completion ports for Windows. The channels. Channels are really fast because they are lock-free most of the time. It's lock-free if you want to write in a non-full channel. It's lock-free if you want to read in an empty channel. It's the other way around, sorry. And the critical section is really short in case you have a blocking call. How does it do it? It uses some atomic operation, lock-free operations that you can do on modern processors, like copy and swap. The mutexes in Go are really fast because they are implemented with futexes. So if you want to see some of the things implemented in this C++, you can go over to this project and discover how you can implement this. Thank you for listening to me. Have a nice day.